the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
It's a very good morning to you all.
Amen.
Welcome to our Mass on this, the 16th Sunday in ordinary time. And as we gather together in the presence of God our Father, we come before him and acknowledge our need for his mercy, to forgive our faults and our failings. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
us pray. This morning's Mass is being celebrated for the special intentions for Deirdre Sharp and John Sharp. Show favour, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God other than you who cares for everything, to whom you might have to prove that you never judge unjustly. Your justice has its source in strength. Your sovereignty over all makes you lenient to all. You show your strength when your sovereign power is questioned, and you expose the insolence of those who know it. But disposing of such strength, you are mild in judgment. You govern us with great lenience. For you have only to will, and your power is there. By acting thus, you have taught a lesson to your people, how the virtuous man must be kindly to his fellow men. And you have given your sons the good hope that after sin, you will grant repentance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And forgiving. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The Spirit comes to help us in our weakness. For when we cannot choose words in order to pray properly, the Spirit Himself expresses our plea in a way that could never be put into words. And God, who knows everything in our hearts, knows perfectly well what He means, and that the pleas of the saints expressed by the Spirit are according to the mind of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus put a parable before the crowds. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everybody was asleep, his enemy came, sowed darnel all among the wheat, and made off. When the new wheat sprouted and ripened, the darnel appeared as well. The owner's servants went to him and said, "Sir, was it not good seed that you sowed in your field? If so, where does the darnel come from?" "Some enemy has done this," he answered. And the servants said, "Do you want us to go and weed it out?" But he said, "No, because when you weed out the darnel, you might pull up the wheat with it. Let them both grow till the harvest. And at the harvest time, I shall say to the reapers, 'First, collect the darnel and tie it in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat into my barn.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Today, more than ever, patience is a forgotten virtue. Our individualistic and materialistic society values ambition and action above all else. Waiting even for the shortest of time has become so unbearable that much of the economy is geared towards eliminating dead time. However, patience, along with its inseparable companions, namely humility, tolerance, generosity, and mercy, is an essential ingredient in God's world. Today's readings speak of mercy, compassion, and patience. The first reading offers a description of God's divine nature, and the author emphasizes God's universal care and patience as signs of strength, characteristics that stand at odds with the worldly values. St. Paul, in the second reading, tells of the consequences of the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in Christian prayer. And St. Paul encourages us to hand over our struggles to the Spirit, who prays deeply in our hearts to our Father in heaven. And this morning's Gospel shares three parables about growth, each seen from a different perspective. The first tells of the wheat and the darnel. It challenges us to recognize that sometimes we must learn to live with situations that we don't like, because the effort to remove or change them would do more harm than good. So it is a shrewd picture of the patience and compassion needed to live with the ambiguities and complexities of everyday life. So in the week ahead, we ask and pray for the deep humility and freedom to give of our best, and also to have faith in the God of surprises.
We now stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, life from life, true God from true God, begotten not made, of us salvation, he came down from heaven.
Lord God is good and forgiving. Inspired by God's mercy and compassion, let us turn to our Father in heaven with our prayers and petitions.
Let us pray for the church. May we, as the members of the body of Christ, always follow the example of the head, your dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray for the elderly. May they receive the support they need from their families and friends, and may they know that you are always with them.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray for those who exercise authority in our world. May they always strive for peace and act together to create justice and prosperity.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray for all those who are marginalized or face discrimination. May our church community always offer them a warm welcome so that they may experience the acceptance that is their due.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray for those who are sick in mind and body, and for all those who are lonely. We pray especially for those mentioned in our sick list and in our book of prayer. May they always know that you are with them in their suffering.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray for all those who have passed away. May the Lord raise them up and receive them into his heavenly home. We pray especially for those who have died recently, including Marina Mulrow, Simon Ripetti, Mark Thomas, and Angela Johnson. We also pray for those whose anniversaries occur at this time, including Mary Freeman, Bob Dowling, Mary Suri, Ted King, George Bryan, Mary O'Leary, and all whose names are placed at Our Lady's Shrine.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us ask Mary, Mother of the Church, to intercede for us as we say together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In brief moment of silence, we make our own petitions to our Father in heaven.
Almighty Father, we ask you to listen to our petitions that we have presented to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
pray now that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Lord,
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Alan our Bishop, all the clergy and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And so at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Communion? Or do you want to bless me?
Christ.
need it. Oi. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Before the final blessing, there is just one announcement, and that is the second collection after all masses this weekend is a collection for the Day for Life. So thank you and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. The Lord be with you. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon us and remain with us always.